page 92. Oh, how I love Jesus. Won't you sing it with all your heart and mean it?
There is a name I love to hear. I love
Jesus, my Lord.
hello to everybody.
Howdy.
Give a hug. Give a hug, tell me you love him.
Get a hug, get a hug.
I'm so glad I'm a part of the family of God. I've been washed in the fountain.
Something in common, thank you. You know, what a mighty God we serve, folks. You know, I'll say it this way. I was even told this morning by one of my bosses that I will probably be short-winded today because I need to get into Houston to take care of some schools that are damaged, try to get it ready for the kids to come in. But you know what? God has blessed us. Some of us had a little few inconveniences over the holidays or the snowbiter, as they want to call it, or whatever you want to call it. But I can tell you, through it all, God was with us.
Yes.
We may have done without lights. We may have done without heat. We may have done without water. But God says this, my grace is sufficient. And you know what? What about all the people that didn't have a home? What about all the people that didn't have a place to go to? What about all the people that may not have had a shower in 3 years and you're worried about 3 days? You know, guess what? You know, when COVID come out, we had a shortage of toilet paper. Now we got a shortage of PVC. Okay? You know, where does it stop? When God says it does.
It did.
You know, but we, and today in our Sunday school lesson, we hit on Jeremiah 29:11. And everybody knows Jeremiah 29:11. It says, for I know the thoughts that I think toward you. But at the end of that verse, it says, for an expected end. You know what? That end may be with the storm going on right here. It may be the whatever your end is classifying it as. Maybe it's getting into heaven and being with the Lord. But God says in His Word that if we don't trust and obey, we're not getting there.
That's right.
And so we're going to talk about that today in our message a little bit, but I know it's not time for my message yet. I'm getting excited and I'm ready to run. Y'all kept me out of the pulpit last Sunday. And so today you're going to suffer for that. So with that being said, let us give God thanks right now.
We should thank God you got to go to work today. Yeah,
I'm thankful for a job. There's a lot of people that would have had that problem. You know, they would love to have a job.
Yes, they would.
You know, they would love to have that privilege. So it is a privilege. It's not a problem. So with that being said, let us go to the Lord. Our most gracious Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you for the abundance that you have provided. Mm-hmm. Father, we have been inconvenienced for a little while. But your word in Ecclesiastes 3 said everything has a season. So Father, thank you for bringing us to the end of that season and bringing us to a new day. Lord, we love you, and we know that, Father, everything we have is because of you. Everything we can do is because of you. Even our voice is because of you. So, Father, we thank you for that privilege. Father, you say to give back a portion of what you've given us through our money, through our time, whatever it may be, Father. Lord, would you be glorified by what you see in us do back to you? Not because of you telling us we have to, because, Father, we love you and we will want to honor and glorify you. Forgive us, Father, for we've fallen short. And we ask these things in Christ Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
I think Sister Raina has our special this morning, the way it appears. So we're going to turn it over to her angelic voice, and we're going to be blessed. Amen.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Good morning.
So how about that storm we had? Everybody make it through? Blessed, right? Well, that's what this song's about. It's just making it through any storm, whether it be COVID or snowvid, we're going to make it through to the end, right, by praising God.
Amen.
So if you know it, sing along, because I'm pretty sure you will.
Even a baby kicking in the middle of the night.
Even a baby kicking in the middle of the night. Hold on, let's start it over. Very beginning, because we got something in common, right? I was sure by now, God, you would have reached down and wiped our tears away, stepped in and saved the day. But once again I say amen, and it's still raining. As the thunder rolls, I barely hear you whisper through the rain, I'm with you. And as your mercy falls, I raise my hands and praise the God. your hand. You never left my side, and though my heart is torn, I will praise you in the storm.
It amazes me how God does what he does and allows us to be a part of his work. You know, it was not until yesterday morning I was out on a job that God affirmed the message for today. And I will promise you, there's going to be people in here that think I am talking about them in this message. But I will promise you, this is not about you. This is about the world. You know, I've listened to more complaints and fussing on social media this past week. I've been without water for 48 hours. I've been without power for 48 hours. I've been this, I've been that. You know what? I even caught myself fussing about having to work on a Saturday. And God reminded me, hey, I can take your job if that's what you want. I can take your livelihood away from you if that's what you want. No, God, I'm good. Thank you. And, you know, it becomes a privilege to be able to do God's work. We have to do all things like we're doing it to the glory of God, right?
Amen.
And so our message this morning is coming out of Philippians 2, and you know, when I say it this way, folks, while you're turning there, didn't God call us to be lights into the darkness?
Yes, he did.
You know what? When hardship comes, when trouble comes, you know, maybe it's our family. Maybe it's our spouse. Maybe it's our job. Maybe it's lights or things that are not really necessity that we have become convenient to liking and thinking we deserve that and more.
Bless you.
Thank you.
And so with that being said, in Philippians chapter 2, we'll start with verse 12. And watch this. It says, wherefore, my beloved, as ye have always obeyed, not as in my presence only, but now much more in my absence, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. For it is God which worketh in you both to will and to do of his good pleasure. Do all things without murmurings and disputings, that ye may be blameless and harmless, the sons of God without rebuke, in the midst of a crooked and perverse nation, among whom ye shine as lights in this world. Let us bow and pray. Our most gracious Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you for having you to come to. But Father, most of all, we find ourselves thinking in the carnal mind that everything is about us and not about you. So, Father, would you forgive us of that? Would you teach us how to take and just glorify your kingdom by our actions, by our words, by our thoughts? But, Father, most of all, by our lives. Father, let us sacrifice our own thoughts today. Let us sacrifice our own emotions today. And Father, let everything we do glorify you and your kingdom. Forgive us for we've fallen short. And we ask these things in Christ Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. You know, folks, I'm going to start off with this, and then I'm going to go into it. Think about it this way. At your very worst, this week, you had no lights for two or three hours, some maybe 2 or 3 days. Some may not have lights yet. You may be doing without water, and you can't find PVC anywhere. You cannot even find a stove to cook with. So you're having to eat out of the can. You know what? How many of those conveniences did Jesus have? Did he even have a sleeping bag to lay down his head on? No. And you know what? We think we deserve all that and more. And so we find ourselves fussing and complaining. And if you don't believe me that social media is full of complaints, all you got to do is turn it on for about 15 minutes.
No, thank you.
And after 15 minutes, you're going to say, Lord, these are people that claim to love you. These are people that claim to know the story of Peter. When Peter was sitting in the boat and you was walking on the water. And Peter said, Lord, if it's you, let me come to you. Even amidst the storm, he was ready to reach out to Jesus. The other disciples in the boat, guess what? Fear stepped in. Now, if you look at that, and how much harm can complaints do? You know, think about it this way. Maybe your neighbors had to do without a little bit. Maybe your neighbor's never seen you under a test. And you're fussing about your lights being out or you can't go anywhere in your car. How many people don't even have a car? They got to walk everywhere they go. Do we realize how much privilege it is that we have those things? Do we realize that God has given us more than we deserve? God could have said, you know what? You don't need a house no more, so here's what I'm going to do for you. I'm going to burn it down. With no insurance. Now what do you got? You go ahead and make a tent, and you grab your sleeping bag, and you enjoy. And you thank God for it. Because a lot of people don't even have the tent. So again, watch this. We do it for the glory of God, not of us, not for our convenience. It says, wherefore, my beloved, as ye have always obeyed. I don't think God's talking to us right there. Because if God was talking to us, he'd say, all those have continued to disobey. Think about that. How many of us like our children when they don't obey us? You tell me that ain't a storm going in. My grandmother used to say all Hades was breaking loose in hers when she had all her grandkids in the house.
Amen.
Because I guarantee you, at the end of the day, her arm had to hurt. Because she done what? And my grandmother had 23 grandchildren.
Yeah.
So if you got 23 kids running around your house, by the time you lay your head on the pillow, your arm's going to be sore. You may not even be able to lift it, knowing you got to do it tomorrow, too. But, folks, we do what we do because of God. God has blessed us to let us stay here.
That's right.
God didn't promise it would be easy. He said, I will be with you always. And you know what? Watch here. You have always obeyed, not only in my presence, but now more in my absence. Do you realize that God expects us to be obedient at all times? You know what? If the boss was around, and you know, this is funny. You can see 20 people sitting around on a stool. Let the boss drive up and then see him. They jump up and go to running and act like they've been doing something. I seen one the other night splashing water in the face like they'd been sweating. Do you think if you can see the boss, he can't see you? He already knows you've been disobedient to what you need to do. God knows it all. God sees it all. God is everywhere. You cannot go and hide something from God. So whatever we're doing in His presence, even though He's not right where we can see Him. Guess what? If you find yourself like the pastor fussing about your job, you can be reminded your job can be taken. You know, how many people would love to be able to work right now, but can't? Maybe disabilities, maybe impairments, maybe handicaps. Do you know how many people would love to have everything that you have?
That's right.
Do you understand that? I have a friend of mine that lost her mother yesterday. She had been with dementia for years. But you know what? As hard a disease as that is, now they have nothing. How many times have they fussed about, well, how hard it is to take care of a patient that doesn't even know you, that may even hit you, may strike you, may do everything of those nature. You know what? How many people woke up this morning and wasn't able to come to church because health not good? But yet there are those that says, you know what? I hadn't been able to walk in years. I hadn't been able to live in years. Are we being obedient to God even in His absence? Are we so full of ourselves that all we think about is how much it inconveniences us? You know, it's only for a little while. Isn't that what Ecclesiastes 3 says? Everything has a season. Everything. But you know what? If whatever you're complaining about, what would you do if God took it away from you?
Complain about something else.
Yeah.
We'd find something else. That's exactly true. But you know what? We would be hollering and screaming at God for taking what we were complaining about and saying, Lord, why did you take that from me?
That's right.
That would be our first complaint, right?
Right.
You know, I found myself talking to God about that when, you know, my mom and dad passed away. God, why did you take them? Because her work was done. There wasn't promise forever here. They're promised forever in the kingdom of heaven. Okay. Well, Lord, I thank you for allowing me the privilege of having them as long as I did. There's a lot of people that don't even know their parents because they grew up without them at all. Much less have memories of them like I have of my mom and dad. You know, folks, we do. We get so wrapped up in the bundle of the way it's given that we forget to thank God in it. You know, Paul says it best when he says, count it all as joy.
Right.
Do you know that if God said, you know what? I need you to pick up your cross today and follow me.
Mm-hmm.
Now with that cross comes a little bit of problem. I'm not going to tell you all the problems. I need you to trust. You know, Brother James said it best in our Sunday school this morning. God only expects us to trust and obey. You know what? How are we obeying when we're fussing? You know, what would happen, you know, if God said this? He says, you know what? I saved you. Now you can do whatever you want to do, and I'm okay with that. But this. When I tell you that's enough, that's enough. I need you to just stop doing it and quit. What's our first question?
Why?
We get mad at a three-year-old and say, man, you got some questions today, don't you? You remember a three-year-old, right? Yeah, they're asking 42,000 questions. And every one of them ends up with why? Why? Because I told you so.
That's right.
Don't worry about why. Just understand, I told you so. God is telling us today, don't worry about why. Because it's for His glory anyway. Well, God, why did you take my lights off? Why did you give me the wrong hamburger the other day? God, you know I cannot stand avocados. Why did you put avocados on my hamburger? And you hear God say, how many would love to have that hamburger? How many of would love to have a meal? You know, there's kids right now in foreign countries that don't have what we have. They're having to go to the road ditch to even get a handful of water for something to drink. And we're sitting there saying, oh, I don't like that label water. I want some Aquafina. I won't drink anything if it's not Aquafina. You know what? If I took the Aquafina out and put tap water in it, you couldn't tell the difference because your mindset's all about that label.
Uh-huh.
Come on. Come on.
That's the truth.
You know, folks, we're so focused on our stuff that we're no longer focused on God and letting God be God.
Right.
Do you understand that God has a purpose for that storm this past week? Maybe it was to take and put you into perspective to remind you of His power.
Okay.
Maybe it was just to take you to the place and point where you said, thank you, Lord, for it being as well as it is.
Amen.
You know, folks, we are so wound up in what's good for us that we forget what's good for God. We forget whose child we are. But that verse, but now much more in my absence. Do you realize that God entrusted you with the world to just be a light in the darkness? Now, when you accepted Jesus as your Savior, you was willing to do anything for that salvation, wasn't you?
Mm-hmm.
But now, why? Why did I got to do that, Lord? Why did you make me have to stay in my house for 3 days and not go out? God said you needed to slow down. You needed some quiet time. You needed to clear your mind up. You need to put your focus back on me. And you know what? That hit me like a ton of bricks. I was so busy with my life that I wasn't focusing on what I needed to focus on. Last Sunday morning, I hate canceling service. I do. Last Sunday morning when the storm come in, we canceled church. I tried my best to do a video there in my living room because I want the word to go out. But you know what? I hadn't got that video off that little square box I call an iPad yet. And I could fuss and complain about it. But you know what? It's not about that. Maybe God doesn't want it to go out. Maybe God said, you know, you're being hard-headed, you're not listening. So sit there and be still for a little bit. Now watch this in verse 13. For it is God which worketh in you both to will and to do His good pleasure. Do you realize that the circumstance you're in right now is not for your good pleasure? It's not for your convenience. It's not for you. Remember what Jeremiah 29:11 says. For I know the thoughts that I think toward you. And guess how it ends? For an expected end. Go ahead, write it down. That way you can go back and look at it and see if I'm telling you the truth. You know, don't forget, it's about God's good pleasure. Well, oh, Pastor, that's only one verse, and you're taking it out of context, really. Romans 8:28 says, all things work together for His good purpose. Maybe this storm is to put you into position to help someone that needs to see Jesus in you.
Come on.
It's not about you. Your life is not about you.
Amen.
When you told God, here am I, use me, save me, guess what you just did? You gave up your rights to have an opinion. You gave up your rights to say, Lord, I don't want to do it this way. Because if you're telling Him how you want it, He's sitting on His throne saying, who are you? What was you when I formed all this? Did you help me create it? Are you higher than I? If not, sit down, shut up, and behave. You know, that's a harsh statement right there, isn't it? Sit down, shut up, and behave. But guess what we do? We start murmuring and complaining and telling God, I don't want to do that. I don't want to work on a Saturday, God. You know I got enough money with 40 hours. Why do I want to work on a Saturday? Because I granted you that privilege. Someone needs to see me on that day. Someone needs to see your heart's been changed. Someone needs to see you giving up your Sunday, putting flower arrangements to bless someone. You know, I heard that story week before last. Well, Pastor, I won't be here next weekend. I'll be, you know, in the privilege of putting flowers together. On a day we call Sweethearts Day. I wonder how many blessings come out of that flower shop.
Yeah.
I wonder how many really stop to think how much love was put into those vases before they went out. How much care. Guess what? I'm gonna tell you a phone number, and I want you to call this number if you think this life is about you. I gave the same phone number to the Sunday school class. It's 1-800, I don't care. You go ahead and call God and tell Him you don't care about His good purpose. You don't care about His good pleasure. You don't care about people living in a lost and dying world going to hell. Go ahead. It's up to you. That's what you're telling God when you tell Him you want it your way. I don't think God says just because He's king, it was Burger King where you get it your way. Y'all do know the slogan for Burger King, right? You come get it your way. But God the King says, it's my way.
Come on.
It's my way. It's for my good purpose. But God, I didn't sign up for it that way.
Yeah, you did.
Well, God, how do you know I did? Well, I know the Word of God says this. Die to yourself daily. Well, God, why? Because I sent my begotten Son to die on a cross for you.
Amen.
Because I gave you my Son for you to have this privilege. Now, who are you?
Yeah.
Come on.
And then you hear God say, why do you want it your way? Oh, aren't we a selfish, greedy nation?
Yes, we are.
You know, folks, I'm telling you, if you don't like what I'm preaching this morning, go ahead and call Facebook and tell them quit posting all the complaints. Do you realize that as Christians, when we're complaining and murmuring, how much harm that's doing to the kingdom of God? When you're fussing about your knee hurt, be reminded of who's in the wheelchair with no legs. When you're complaining of a headache, be thankful. There's a lot of people that wish they even could feel the pain of a headache. You know, I know we tease each other about murmuring and complaining. But I can tell you one thing. God's not about your complaint. He's not here for your complaint.
That's right.
He really don't care about your complaint. Unless you're complaining that he's not using you enough. How many of y'all are willing to step out and come to the altar this morning and say, Lord, forgive me, for I haven't given you enough. Lord, will you use me today for someone lost and dying? Someone going to hell? Lord, that soul you paid for, just like you did mine. Can I be your hands and feet during this time? Can I go out into a lost and dying world and let my light shine today? You know, God's asking you that. And he's expecting an answer. But that's between you and him. You can choose who you will serve on this day. You can serve yourself, or you can serve God. Because God has an expected end, with or without you. And you know, folks, I told you that I won't have you out already. But as your pastor, if I let you go out of here without verse 15, that ye may be blameless and harmless, the sons of God, without rebuke in the midst of a crooked and perverse nation among whom ye serve, or shine as lights in the world.
Yes.
Do you realize that God has just told you you are a light into the darkness? Do you realize that people are dying and going to hell in the darkness? Do you realize that God has granted you the privilege with his creation? And he says, trust me and follow me. What's it say in the book of Matthew? Trust me, follow me, and I will make you fishers of men. Sometimes that means getting in a boat, going out into the water that you don't know if you're going to catch fish or not. But when you get to shore and you don't have no food, and you hear the words of Christ, throw the net on the other side of the boat. Well, Lord, we've been fishing all night. We ain't caught nothing anyway. I'm not throwing that net out there. And he says, just put it out there. Sit down, shut up, behave, do what I tell you to do. And then all of a sudden, the nets begin to break because of the abundance that God's given you. You know what? Maybe God's only abundance of giving you is just one soul. Maybe you're the next Billy Graham and you got 10 million people waiting for you to get there where they can hear your voice. Whatever, wherever, it is for God's good pleasure, not yours. So I'm going to tell you as your pastor, and I'm rude today, sit down. Shut up and listen.
And
say,
you.
Lord, here am I. Thank you for making it as well for me as it is.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you for giving me what I have. Because, Lord, from this point forward, it's all about you. It's not about me. I will promise you, you'll wake up with a different attitude tomorrow morning. If you get to wake up at all. Remember, we talked about this in our Sunday school hour this morning. When you keep telling God you don't care, what happens when He takes your breath? What happens when He takes what you're complaining about away from you? What happens when you're asking God for years for a miracle? And God says, not yet. Time's coming. Only God deserves praise today.
Amen.
Only God deserves glory today.
Amen.
So with that being said, let me pray for you, and then we'll get our musicians up here for an invitation. Our most gracious Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank You for loving us and trusting us into the crooked, perverse world that we live in. Father, You could have took us home in the twinkle of an eye. But Lord, You entrusted us to stay and do the work that You set forth for us to do. Father, would You remind us today that without You we have nothing, but with You we have everything. Lord, there's no lights that's going to go off in the kingdom of heaven, because You are the light. There's no manna that will have to come from heaven to feed us, because You're our daily bread. And Lord, there's no sin that will take us to hell, because You're our Savior. So Lord, would You be glorified in our life and our world today, and use us for Your good pleasure. Forgive us where we've hardened and said, I don't care. Lord, be glorified is all You can. And we ask these things in the sweet, holy name of Jesus Christ. Amen. You know, folks, I'm going to have our musicians come up and do an invitation just for a few moments. You know, I don't think there's a one of us that I'm looking for salvation as much as I'm looking for those that say, Lord, here am I. Use me today. Be glorified in all things that I do. God's saying today, there's room at the cross for you. Are you looking for your spot there? Are you willing to say, Lord, here am I, use me today? Be glorified in what you see in me today, Father. Thank you. Amen. You know, I want to say this before I let you go out to the wolves, you know. You understand one thing? The lights you've been complaining about not having this week, have you thanked God for the privilege of having the funds to even pay for your light bill to begin with? Because He could take them away from you. You could constantly be in a darkness. But guess what? God chose to let you have lights. God chose to let you have a life. God chose to let you have a job. Or a roof over your head. So you know what? We need to go out with a smile so big that we're getting lipstick on both earlobes today. I would say that, you know, you need to get your smile as big as my belly. But I've already seen the repercussions of what happens when the belly begins to jump. So with that being said, let me pray for you. Yes, ma'am? Tonight is canceled. Okay. Joe and Beverly was exposed to COVID again.
Oh my gosh.
So I guess they're under quarantine, or they got it. One of the two. They received the first shot of the COVID deal, but when I talked to Joe Thursday, they had some symptoms that, you know, either from being exposed to it or getting the shot. You know, I've heard people getting it when they get the shot. So either way, you know, pray for them. Pray for the ones that lost loved ones here in the past few days. Pray for those that have even taken and you know, lost jobs because of this. They lost finances because of this. So guess what? Some of us didn't lose a penny over it. We just were inconvenienced for a moment. We thank God for that.
Amen. Amen.
Let us go to the Lord and we'll be dismissed. Most gracious Heavenly Father, Lord, thank you for loving us so much to give us what you've given us. Father, if we have nothing at all but you, we have everything we need. So, Father, would you remind us who you are, what you're capable of doing, and that, Father, use us as that vessel, as a mouthpiece into a crooked and perverse world. Let our light shine today, Father, as only they can shine for you. And we ask these things in Christ Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Folks, I will tell y'all, if y'all need me, I'll be on my phone next week or so. I will probably be working late. And if you need me, call me.
And you're going to let us know about Wednesday?
I'm sure Wednesday will probably be canceled, but if it changes, I'll call you. How's that?
That's good. Yeah. Everything. Healthy. You know, you do what you can. Yes. You know what you're doing. You know that you were without water.
Yeah, I told him while ago, you know, to blow the flames over.
There's plenty of gasoline, you just couldn't get it. Right, because of the mechanism.
Thanks,
we're only a phone call away, too.
Y'all have a good week.
You too.